Hello friends, welcome to UGC EEPG Pathshala. Myself, Dr. Taruna Bansal, Assistant Professor at Department of Geography, Jamia Millia Islamia, will speak on Hartshorne-Schaefer, or rather Schaefer-Hartshorne debate in geography, which is part of the paper Geographical Thought. In this module, we are not, you know, I have not mentioned any of the objectives because the entire purpose of mentioning or rather discussing this debate is to understand what was the reason that this debate became so popular and is part of the geographical thinking. So I start with the introduction. The debate on the methodology of pursuing geographical studies that ensued between the two geographers, Schaefer and Richard Hartshorne, is one of the most stimulating and academic exchanges the subject of geography has witnessed. This debate began with Schaefer's paper titled Exceptionalism in Geography, a Methodological Examination, which was published in the Annals of the Association of American Geographers in September 1953. Schaefer's article was published posthumously and the debate continues as Richard Hartshorne published his comments in the same journal in 1954. Followed by an elaborate titled article Exceptionalism in Geography Re-examined. This was again published in the same journal in September 1955. Richard Hartshorne also published another article in the same journal in June 1958 titled The Concept of Geography as a Science of Space from Kant and Humboldt to Hettner. Drawing from the research articles mentioned above, the debate on the methodological position of geography that arose in the academic circles of the United States in the 1950s may be charted out. Exceptionalism in geography. So now in this particular section, we'll be discussing the concept of exceptionalism as given by Schaefer. In the early 1950s, the geographers in the United States were highly influenced by the regional paradigm as the chosen methodological frame for pursuing geographical research. The most celebrated proponent of this particular regional paradigm was Richard Hartshorne. He was also from the United States. And Hartshorne's seminal monograph named The Nature of Geography appeared in the Annals and which was later published in the form of a monograph by Association of American Geographers. Though Hartshorne's paradigm of regional geography was well received, there arose disillusionment and discontent in accepting regional paradigm as the most accepted way of doing geography among certain sections of geographers within the United States. Schaefer was a trained economist and later pursued geography. Schaefer was associated with the Department of Geography at the University of Iowa and he had migrated to the United States to escape the Nazi persecution that was taking place in the then Germany. Schaefer took it upon himself to clarify the position of geography within the broad arrangement of various schemes of knowledge systems, the sciences and the social sciences. His motive was to refute the preeminence given to regional paradigm of geography as the only mode of conducting geographical research. And for that, he reinterpreted the works of scholars whom Richard Hartshorne had used in his monograph. Schaefer's rebuttal to the Hartshorneian tradition of regional paradigm came in the form of a research article published posthumously in 1953. This was published in Annals of the Association of American Geographers. It is in this paper that he takes up the cause of systematic geography while rejecting the claim of exceptionalism of geography. The claim for exceptionalism in geography emerged from the notion that the core focus of geography should be areal differentiation. Geography should be studied as a science that explains the realities of areal differentiation that appears on the surface of the earth. The differences between these regions need attention of geographers as well as the combination of all these aspects present on those spaces and how they are different from other places or regions. In this manner, geographical research would be able to put forward an accurate, orderly, rational description and interpretation of the variable character of the Earth's surface. And here I would like to mention one thing, that this particular definition of geography is regarded as one of the best definition ever given by any geographer till date. The aim of the geographical research according to Hartshorne is to gain complete understanding of the areal differentiation of the Earth. For that, geography must focus on the synthesis of all phenomena occurring in a particular region. The region too would get its identity from the synthesis of the various phenomena present in the region. Hartshorne also leans on the Kantianian tradition and draws an analogy between history and geography, saying that as history divides time into sections, so geography divides space into sections. Geography thus studies the world and describes and interprets different regions as they appear in a particular time. What other disciplines study as heterogeneous phenomenon, geography studies those entire phenomena in combination. By doing this, geography puts together the aspects which other disciplines study in isolation. For looking at phenomena in combination, geography must use descriptive mode of analysis. For Hartshorne, the raison d'etre of geography is the study of areal differentiation. So it can be best expressed through regional geography. Regions are categorized into formal regions, functional regions. Formal regions are those where the entire region has homogeneous phenomenon, while functional regions are those where the unity of the region depends on the node which controls the flow of the phenomenon across space, thus carving out a functional region. Regional paradigm thus acquired the status of the most feasible methodology of conducting geographical research, as regional geography brought together various aspects of spatial character which are dealt separately in topical geography. This method of bringing together a phenomenon and their interaction with each other to give special character to a region was analyzed in geographical research. Even within topical specializations, study of regions had an important role to offer. If we take an example of relating economics and economic geography and applying the theories and laws of economics to geography, the focus of a geographer is distinguished from that of an economist. His application of the economic theories would be over and within regions. Hartshorne also elucidated the inquiry of generic problems rather than causal relationships while undertaking geographical research. He was keener on the functional representation of the phenomenon on the Earth's surface rather than how each phenomenon leaves its imprint on the surface of the Earth. With the focus on the organization and arrangement of phenomenon on the surface of the Earth as the primary research objective of geography, inquiring into the causality of the assemblage of phenomenon took a back seat, challenging the claim for exceptionalism in geography. The descriptive methodology for doing geographical research met with resistance among those practitioners of the discipline who were of the opinion that geography should also be a law-making discipline and not remain only as a discipline which deals with descriptive methods. Schaefer became the voice of the discontented geographers and took it on himself to write an article challenging the exceptionalist claim for geography and urging geographers to adopt the methods used by the positivist school of research, because this may help to elevate the discipline to the status of a law-making social science. Schaefer's thoroughly well-researched article attempts to dispel the confusion on the nature of the discipline of geography, and it is attempted as it was attempted by earlier geographers whom Hartshorne referred to while upholding regionalism as the only method to be followed by geographers. Schaefer contested treating all historical accounts of the development of the discipline as method of teaching the same. Methodology deals with position of the discipline. Vis-a-vis, the systems of knowledge and methodology undergoes constant evolution and change with passage of time. The scope and content of geography as viewed by geographers have been apologetic and is always eager to justify the very existence of the discipline by offering it the status of integrating science. It has been agreed that the progress of geography has been slower compared to other social sciences like economics, but yet it is undoubtedly an important discipline. In the 19th century, the growth of the natural sciences elucidated the fact that mere descriptive study would not elevate a discipline to the status of science. The laws that geography may come up with are mostly about formation of patterns which are spatial in nature. Humboldt and Ritter, the founding fathers of the modern geography, too accepted the fact that all spatial patterns are governed by laws, including those created by natural phenomena and man. Schaefer looks into the works of Victor and Kraft that geography is a science trying to discover laws that are related to the surface of the earth. With this, Schaefer brings the case for systematic geography, where spatial relations of two or more phenomena is studied over the entire earth's surface to arrive at a generalization or a law. He blames the lack of clarity on the relative role and importance of regional and systematic geography to differential preference given to the two methods at different phases of the development of the discipline. In the beginning of the 19th century, physical geography applied systematic method, while at the beginning of the 20th century, the shift occurred towards research in human and social geography. And since not much of social geography or other social sciences based laws had developed during that period, the systematic method floundered. Generalization was found unpractical, and the practitioners of geography aligned themselves with the opponents of the scientific method. Schaefer then quotes Hittner and dispels misconception on the word dualism for geography. According to Schaefer, dualism was not used to emphasize that geography is a methodologically unique discipline, nor is the complexity a regional geographer faces is facile. Schaefer also delves into the historical roots of this uniqueness of geography, which he terms as exceptionalism here. He calls Immanuel Kant as the father of exceptionalism, but terms him as a poor geographer of the 18th century when compared to Varenius. Kant claimed exceptionalism not only for geography, but also for history. He categorizes history and geography both as descriptions, with history is a description according to time, while geography is that of space. This distinction, according to Schaefer, is untenable, as no systematic discipline can ignore both the coordinates, be it time or space. Secondly, simply because Kant says that both the disciplines are descriptive, there are no laws in the two disciplines. Humboldt, too, in his celebrated publication, known as Cosmos, explains that all sciences research for law and are nomothetic in nature. Schaefer also accuses use of Hettner's great prestige to create more confusion about the exceptionalist claim by drawing spurious similarities between history and geography. It is through Hartshorne that the American geographers have been acquainted with Hettner's work, but Schaefer feels Hettner's work can be equally supportive of nomothetic method applied in geography. But the impact of exceptionalism on geography has been deep, and it needs the dispelling of the misconception around it. One way geography is different from other sciences is that sciences progress towards formulation of laws, but geography is essentially morphological. So often, time factor is ignored by the geographers. The breakdown of causality in geographical research led to its failure as a discipline. The morphological character is often represented by maps as a tool, and maps are selective, since only certain features that are of interest to the researcher are mapped, and also help in correlating phenomena spatially. This method is termed as comparative geography, but is in reality a systematic geography. Quoting Palander, Schaefer also tells that the notion of regions explains nothing and is no substitute for a spatial law. By rejecting the formulation of scientific laws, the possibility of prediction is compromised by the discipline. Laws of geography can be categorized into three classes. Laws of physical geography fall in the first category. The laws of economic geography are of the second category, while the third category is the non-morphological laws. Mature social sciences look for process laws. If geographers do not pursue systematic method and strive to formulate laws, it might lead to geographical isolationism among other disciplines, as search for laws can occur only with the cooperation from other sciences, especially social sciences. Schaefer recommends pursuing systematic method for enhancing the prospects of the discipline. He casts his doubt on the future of geographical research. If geographers restrict themselves to the search of regions and not align themselves with other systematic sciences. We come to the next section, exceptionalism in geography re-examined. Richard Hartshorne expressed his reaction to Schaefer's paper in the form of his articles, which were published in the same journal, Annals of the Association of the American Geographers, in year 1955 as well as in 1958. In 1954, too, a brief comment was published by him, which was a caveat to the geographers to critically look into Schaefer's paper, and that he would publish the clarifications on his work, The Nature of Geography. In his article titled Exceptionalism in Geography Re-examined, published in 1955, caused it the correction to the false representations and accusations made by Schaefer in his 1953 article. He also admits that his paper does not deal with only negative purpose of claiming all that Schaefer has written is false, but he too, in the process of writing the clarifications, learnt a lot on the type of methodology that is suitable for geographical research. As Schaefer noted that methodological discussions are dialectical, knowledge may be derived from mutual discussion and debate. He also notes down the rules for methodological writing in this paper. The need for re-examination of the exceptionalist claim for geography arises, according to Hartshorne, since the article by Schaefer remains in the annals for future students to be misguided. It's important that the clarifications are presented. Hartshorne writes that methodological studies on geography have been most influential in Germany, who have altered their view from the earlier geographers. He names Hettner and also Kraft and Humboldt, saying that the writings of Humboldt mentioned by Schaefer does not have any methodological topics, and Kraft's essays has been mentioned yet not considered. Most other important authors like Richthofen, Mackinder, Willock or Saar have not been mentioned by Schaefer. The students thus may be led to almost devastating conclusions. He also claims that the basic purpose of the essay written by Schaefer is unclear, and leads to another major issue of exceptionalism, which in reality does not exist. The major thrust of the essay is that geography must be a science that searches for laws, and no new arguments have been presented. Texts which reject scientific determinism, like that of Hettner, has been attacked, as well as Hartshorne's own The Nature of Geography. The article exposes defective scholarship, assertions without supporting evidence. By organizing the paragraphs and arguments in a rather confusing way, the readers are brought into having the same opinion as the critique. The major targets of Schaefer's essay are the writings of Hettner as well as that of Hartshorne. Certain views about a few authors have also been proven as wrong directly or by implication. Even false translations have been used in the essay to present false impressions of the original works of the writers. The falsification and fabrication of the facts had been deliberately made, and writers have been distorted to generate opposing opinion of the readers. Hartshorne's sharper critique of Schaefer's work came in the form of his 1959 monograph, The Perspective on the Nature of Geography. In this monograph, Hartshorne defines the discipline of geography as one, within quotes, which seeks to describe and interpret the variable character that exists from place to place on the earth as the world of man. According to Hartshorne, the physical and the human aspects of an area need not be dealt with separately, but as an assemblage of the interaction between the human aspects with the physical factors. The reliance on the previous paradigm of environmental determinism shapes the understanding of the way the human aspects in a region would adapt and respond to the physical aspects of the region. He also considers the division of geography into physical and human aspects as totally unfortunate. By splitting the subject matter into two, geographers would lose out on integrating both the aspects, namely physical and human, while undertaking their research. Hartshorne also clarified the differences between exploratory description and explanatory description while adopting the descriptive science methodology in research. Hartshorne warns that this explanatory description of the former geographies or assemblages should not be given preeminence while doing geographical research. In his account, historical geography should not be undertaken not to ascertain origins of the phenomena, but to offer a better understanding of the present phenomenon in the light of the past. Hartshorne, however, accepted that there is always a possibility of collaboration across the spectrum of methodologies of regional and systematic geography. He said that those researchers who are engaged in organizing aerial differentiation of elementary complexes in large scale, like the entire world, can be linked with those researchers who are involved in deciphering complex relationships of phenomenon over small scale regions. He calls them topical studies and regional studies, respectively. Geographical studies apply both the methods while conducting research, and no one method can be called more important than the other or more appropriate than the other. Integration of both the methods is also possible. Schaefer tried to raise another important issue regarding geography being ideographic or nomothetic discipline. Schaefer asked whether geography should formulate scientific laws or indulge in descriptive analysis of individual cases. Hartshorne was of the opinion that since scientific laws requires abundance of cases to prove itself and that geographical research limits itself to limited numbers of observation, so geographers should refrain themselves from formulating scientific research. He also said that scientific laws are best tested in the laboratories and geographers usually not in the position to conduct their experiments in their laboratory. Hartshorne also opined that the interpretation of the scientific laws requires training in systematic sciences, which the geographers lack, and may not be in a position to offer the right interpretation of the phenomenon. He further states that scientific laws also rely on some form of determinism. When conducting research on human subjects, such determinism appears inappropriate, as difference in human ideas leads to landscape variations. For the reasons mentioned above, Hartshorne therefore suggests that geographers should stay away from searching laws in geography. He also reiterated his support to Hettner's classification of geography as chronological science and history as chronological science, bringing back Kantian idea of history divides through knowledge through time while geography through space. Geographers in their research have also tried to integrate topical and regional aspects within demarcated areas of research, thereby often integrating both the technologies. Hartshorne's idea regarding geography were based on how geography as a research area was shaping up during his times in United States. Schaefer, on the contrary, wrote about what geography was not. By that, Schaefer wanted geography to incorporate aspects of research the discipline was neglecting, and how geography could claim its lawful place within the realm of social science research. Now we come to the conclusions. The debate that ensued between Schaefer and Hartshorne was one of the rare exchanges one finds in the discussion on the methodological aspect to be adopted within the discipline of geography. During the mid-20th century, many schools of geography in the United States were tired of the regional paradigm and were willing to adopt a more rigorous paradigm for doing their research. With this debate spreading across academia, the gradual change towards topical specialism as a methodology was witnessed in geography. Thank you.